Thank you for introduction. Good morning, everyone. Okay, good morning. I'm Masawata from Japan, AIST. This project, Magneto Haptics, is a challenging and novel approach to estimate and create haptic sensation only using magnet, permanent magnet. So in our daily life, there's many use cases of magnetic attraction, like using physical phenomena. Our lives are getting more useful and functional. So I thought how we can use this physical force for the context of HCI. So this is the idea. I have some personal motivation on magnets. So first one is that the magnet is powerful too in physical world. And as like my previous work named Flux Paper, it is look like normal post-it or paper, but actually it has powerful magnetic layer backside, and it works as an animated object or robot in the physical environment. So when connecting pieces of this paper, it gives force feedback by magnetic attraction or repulsion. And one day, when I was using magnets for building blocks with Lego, I found magnet has clear potential in physics, haptics for user interface area. So my question was, is it possible to estimate and create haptic feedbacks only using magnets, like sliding, pushing, and rotating for controlling values for computer devices? And I also realized magnetic sensation is like a gradient curve, although actual setup of haptic mechanism with magnet is shown on the left side. But human feels it as like right side. So this is the key of this project, which is converting magnetic force into visual and intuitive representation. And this video shows a clear goal of this project. By putting on transparent plastic plate with embedded magnets, and by sliding round magnet, and fingertips feels feedback corresponding to the curved graph in yellow color. So the round magnet stops in the middle of the slope of the pass and go back to the right side when the finger removed. So it was achieved only using permanent magnet. Before technical details, I'd like to summarize difference between electronic approach and magnet haptics approach. There are some differences between magnet haptics and traditional electronic approach, such as motor and vibrations. Of course, magnetic force is passive, so that's totally different from motor or vibration. However, most of the time, when users are having some object and move it, and they get the haptic sensation from that object. So passive sensation is also useful in the mechanical design or fabrication. And permanent magnet doesn't need power supply and also save the space for it. And it is also very easy to create physical functions. So I used the permanent magnet for designing haptics. So here's listed research question for me. How to create to estimate haptic sensation, and how to visually represent magnet haptics, and also is magnet haptics practical for haptic sensation? And I'm going to solve and contribute with near real time and scalable calculation method and intuitive and visual representation of feedbacks and user study for validation of magnet haptics. Now, you must be very curious about how to design magnet haptics with your computers. then I show it. The first process is to define some magnets with parameters in a text file, like size, or position, or rotation of each magnet. Then the path where the movable object moves also should be written in the same file, and then put those parameters into calculation program to get the result. Then the program visualizes haptic feedback, haptic force feedback in 3D. And here, haptic force feedback is defined as haptic potential. I describe this reason in a later slide. And next, OpenSCAD helps generate a STL file for 3D printing. And finally, we can get a fabricated object with some spaces for magnets inside. So we can insert magnet inside the ABS plastic. And yes, that's the process of making the blocks with magnet haptics. And then first, three steps iteration process. So we can iterate this process and update for the desired haptic sensation. And this is how the haptic sensation is actually designed in the computer. And maybe, with editing the REST side, the parameter of rotations, estimated haptics potential showing the screen was changed. It is also possible to create Lego-like block with the 3D model. Now the program shows animation of force feedback in 3D axis. And finally, this block is complete. The block contains some magnets on the several different haptic sensations. So there's four types of haptic sensation, each according to the shape and position of magnetic inside. So it is possible to combine some blocks to explore a new scenario of haptic feedback. And yeah, like this. And these each four blocks was also used in user studies. Okay. And let's move to the difficult part of this paper, mainly physics and electromagnetism. So please don't sleep at the morning. There's mainly two famous approaches to calculate or solve electromagnetism. The one is FEM, which creates meshes and solve the problem. The second one is dipole method, which uses plots to plots of vectors in the arbitrary spaces. So in this paper, we selected dipole method to use. Dipole method is open boundary approach, so it is easier to define the largest space for blocks or the embedded magnets, and it is also rapid and still precise when high resolution. And it is also open boundary and vector-based, so the scalability is also high. And here's some quick description on dipole method. So it is invited as a fast and approximate method by Jung in 1998, and it uses differential operation to skip integral operation. So it's very simple and fast approach. And also, it is used in CG animation research. Then in this project, dipole method was upgraded with GPGPU calculation and matrix operation. and intuitive visualization for more understanding about the magnet haptics. And this is a simple representation of magnet haptics. Here is graph named haptic potential. This is a new expression of magnetic force feedback defined this paper. If we insert some magnets more, it's changed. So the upper sample is a general one with the magnetic force. So because the force changes according to the distance. But it's also possible to create the linear distribution on force. So it's a kind of the one of the contribution of magnet haptics. From this slide, I describe how to estimate haptic potential. For dipole method, we use the small magnetic moment shown as M here. And then this formula is of force F applied to M in magnetic field B. And next, we need to think about magnetic force caused by other magnet. So here B at M is calculated with this formula. Then we can gather all B from each cells of magnet. Then we can get the summary of B from the other magnet. And using those two formulas, we can solve the force between the magnets. The dipole method converts those into another approximate expression after differential operation like this. So the force applied to the piece of magnet cell represents magnet moment is Fk, and summary of force applied to left magnet from right is now F, which is summary of Fk. Finally, we can get force between two groups of magnets, shown as two objects with embedded magnets. Ft is a summary of force between summary of force with all combination of magnetic force. But Ft is still a 3D expression, so we have to convert it to another expression. For getting intuitive and impressive visual expression of haptic feedback, I referred work done by a force over the x-axis. The shape of work done by the force is very corresponding to the sensation on the finger when the magnet is moved. So haptic potential represents as P, which is gained by integral of Ft times cosine theta. Oh, I have to hurry up, sorry. Okay, that's how to speed up this approach with using GPU. So finally, it gets 10 times faster than CPU method, CPU approach. And okay, to make sure the dipole method is valid for magnet haptics, so here's a comparison with FEM. There's some difference between our method and FEM in z-axis, but haptic potential is also same. And with different configuration of magnets, it's also same. So I described two of three here. And the last, we have to validate magnet haptics in user study. We hired 9 people in our lab, and their average age was 35.6, and we gave enough basic information about this object contains magnet, so it makes happy sensation. And we gave enough time to exercise, and we waited for answer until submission. The first user study was distinction test to ask subjects to guess which is the correct answer between ABCD and the 4 types of curves, like this. And the result is like this. So I intentionally selected the similar curves, so some subjects confused. But basically, the result was better than my expectation. And on the left side of graph, half of participants could answer correctly. And three made mistake one, and subject six is not good at this sensation. So she or he get the average down. So as a result, it can be said magnet haps is technically distinguishable at least. And also did sensitive test with Likert scale in five levels. So seeing this, each curve has different trend and seems to be well distributed. Okay, so until here, I described all listed here. And finally, prior to submission, I asked some people for some supports about brushing up my idea and papers. So I'd like to take this opportunity to thank them all so much. Thank you for listening. I'd like to take any question.
Wonderful. So great speaker, great talk. We have time for a few questions, so please come up to the microphones and yeah.
Yeah, I'm Honda from MBC. So I have two questions. So first question is, currently the design system is not very good, intuitive, GUI-based. So do you have any plan to make GUI-based the design system? This is question one. The second question is, the current system is just generates static, the magnetic, so potentials. Do you have any plan for realizing any kinds of dynamic, so magnetic field?
Okay, thank you for question. For first one, maybe we can use 3D modeling software like Blender for plugins, so we can get GUI-based interface for designing magnet haptics, I think. But it is not my work, so I just skip this part. And for second question, I think it is possible to make dynamic changing about magnet haptics with changing the part inside the box or object each by each. Maybe it is possible with using electromagnets, but electromagnet is not such powerful like permanent magnets, so I didn't expect that part in
okay,
my
thanks.
Yeah, thank you.
Hi, Dan Ashbrook, University of Copenhagen. I'm curious, your setup here is you put down some magnets in the software and then you get this force curve out, the haptic potential curve. Can you go in the other direction? Can you define a curve and then have the system calculate the kind of magnets you would need to have?
Sorry?
So can I input the haptic potential curve and have output of a magnet arrangement?
Yeah, I think it's possible, but I didn't solve that problem. Maybe you can do that.
No, I'm really bad at math. Maybe
yes,
we can work
mathematics.
Together.
Thank you.
Great. So let's thank our speaker for this great talk.